During this year's Republican National Convention, a Republican representative, Steve King from Iowa, was asked on the air on MSNBC to defend the lack of diversity of the speakers over the course of the 4 days in Cleveland. And his defense was, and I quote, "I'd ask you to go back through history and figure out where are these contributions that have been made by these other categories of people that you're talking about." And basically what he was saying was that you're asking for representation of these subgroups, yet these subgroups don't contribute to society and therefore shouldn't speak on its behalf and how it should be shaped going forward. And he was totally serious with that comment, and there are a number of people who would agree with him. And I think that the best way to combat ignorance is with education. And if the textbooks won't do it, if the history textbooks won't do it, then perhaps Hollywood will. I don't know why education so often has to fall to entertainment. And it's dangerous because sometimes entertainment gets it wrong, or they become obsessed with only a certain part of history, right? I know a number of you have been complaining that movies featuring black characters are usually only about slavery or the civil rights movement, when there's so much more that defines this subgroup. And that's, you know, that's a really, and also I have to say, Hollywood's partially responsible for how Steve King sees subgroups, because they often whitewash roles and take achievements by subgroups and give them to white actors. So that also creates the problem. So Hollywood giveth and Hollywood taketh away. But here they give us the true story of a number of African-American female scientists who actually helped create the space program. And this is a wonderful story. I'm so glad that it's being told, but I am nervous as to the quality of this, of the filmmaking. I think they might be going in the direction of The Help or The Blind Side. Two Oscar-winning movies, by the way, but it's tough, though, that type of film. And also you can only have them so often. So I don't know if a film like this could be as competitive. Also, I feel with Taraji P. Henson being the biggest name, and Octavia Spencer, of course, already has her Oscar, and Taraji P. Henson now is best known for television, that could also potentially hurt the film. But let's take a look. I hope that it's as good as the story deserves it to be.
Equilateral. Trapezoid, isosceles, tetrahedron.
I have never seen a mind like the one your daughter has. You have to see what she becomes.
That's really cool.
Move like that.
Catherine, we all gonna end up unemployed riding around in this pilot. Jump.
You're welcome to walk the 16 mile.
Or sit in the back of the bus.
You kiss me up.
You have identification on?
We're just on our way to work at NASA, sir.
I had no idea they hired.
There are quite a few women working in the space program.
You know what we're doing here? We're putting a human on top of a missile, shooting them into space, and it's never been done before. I need a mathematician that can look beyond the numbers. Math that doesn't yet exist. Before the Russians plant a flag on the damn moon.
You have someone? Running what
I'm playing. Catherine's a gal for that. She can handle any numbers you put in front of her.
Don't embarrass me.
This wasn't empty last night.
I'm sorry, I'm not the...
That Colonel Jim is a tall glass of water.
He's coming over.
Now, why would he be doing that?
Because Mary's waving at him.
No!
Dorothy, slice of pie?
I love one.
You already have a slice of pie, Dorothy. Oh,
left. You're a computer at NASA. They let women handle that sort of...
Yes, it's an uphill battle.
Yes, they let women do some things at NASA, Mr. Johnson. And it's not because we wear skirts. It's because we wear glasses.
We go from being our father's daughters to our husband's wives to our baby's mothers.
You've been gone for 300 hours.
Was Mama gone for 12 and a half days?
No, but it felt like it.
It felt like it to me, too.
It's crunch time. In 14 days, astronauts will be here for training. Everything we do is going to matter to their wives, to their children. I believe it's going to matter to the whole damn country.
My gals are ready. We can do the work.
That's John Glenn.
What do you ladies do for NASA?
Calculate your
launch and landing, sir.
Engineering. And I'm proud as the devil to be working with you.
How could you possibly be ugly in these white men?
It's equal rights. I have the right to see fine in Africa.
There's no protocol for women attending.
There's no protocol for a man circling the earth either, sir.
Every time we have a chance to get ahead, they move the finish line. Every time.
We all get there together, we don't get there at all.
Yeah, it's good to know NASA hadn't given up on good old-fashioned brain power.
Let me ask you, if you were a white male, would you wish to be an engineer?
I wouldn't have to. I'd already be one.
Don't you know that we're able?
That looks fabulous. That looks so good. I don't know why it doesn't have, I don't know if it looks like Oscar material. I think it's a little, potentially a little too upbeat. Oscars like people to really struggle, and these people seem pretty happy throughout the entire movie. I mean, they seem ticked off, but it seems not to have the gravitas of an Oscar-winning film. I think it looks spectacular. And I would also like to point out that some people consider women to be a subgroup as well, which is super frustrating. I think that this is very relatable. I think the acting looks spectacular. I can't believe that Jim Parsons didn't get a single line in the trailer. That's a multi-Emmy winning actor there. Maybe they're like, can't get two TV here. We've already got Taraji P there. But, you know, they're making it seem a little bit like most of the people at NASA are super nice. But then where are these women? You know, I don't think NASA's obviously done very much to promote them and make sure that they were remembered, which is unfortunate. So that should be remembered. But this looks really, really good. I think that although I worry that in an effort to maybe make the film not seem too SJW, they might have robbed it of some of, you know, the weight that it should have to not only be competitive for award season, but something that people maybe feel is worth seeing in the theater. This, to me, I think to a lot of people would be a rental. Not to me. It looks amazing. But, you know, I feel in some ways it speaks to concerns that I have, not only for others, but for myself. But anyway, I'm curious. What do you think? Do you think it's a good awards contender? Do you think it's something you'd pay to see in the theater? And what do you think of the choices that they've made creatively? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for watching with me. And you can check out some more episodes right now.